They are three of the deadliest and most powerful characters to ever be introduced within the Dragon Ball franchise, and alone have stood the test of time by displaying their incredible feats and powers. But what would happen if we put all three of these warriors in one place and have them battle to the death? On today's video, we will be discussing yet another Dragon Ball What If triple threat battle involving Super Saiyan Blue, Kaioken times 20 Goku, Merged Zamasu, and God of Destruction Toppo, and seeing how each character would fare up against the other and who the community thinks would emerge as the last man standing by the end. So buckle up tight and hold on to your seats, because we are going to be entering the ultimate death battle involving Goku, Zamasu, and Toppo next.
This is the legendary Super Saiyan. Before I destroy you, I'm going to need you to subscribe to UnrealEntGaming and turn on notifications to never miss a single upload. Also, follow UnrealEntGaming on these social media platforms. And if you don't, I'll destroy you along with your entire planet.
What, Broly?
Frieza.
Uh-oh.
Prepare to die!
It is a no-holds-barred triple threat battle involving three of the most powerful characters from the Dragon Ball universe, that being Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken times 20 Goku, Merged Zamasu, and Hakaishin Toppo, and the situation being, what if it was possible for all three of these characters to gather together in battling to see which one of these three fighters would emerge as the superior and dominant warrior by the end? As joining me here today to talk about this Dragon Ball triple threat what if battle is my good friend EmoshIslive. Now Emish, this is a very interesting battle considering what we've seen from each individual character, that being Zamasu, Toppo, and Goku, in their own separate moments and seeing what each character was capable of when facing off against somebody more superior, if not equal to in power. And for me, considering their skill sets, their abilities, and their feats, I do believe that in terms of durability, it's highly possible for someone like Merged Zamasu to carry on over and holding the upper hand in terms of durability, and seeing how he was able to fare up against Super Saiyan Blue Vegito. But also in terms of skill set and pure techniques, I think Goku definitely holds the advantage over both Zamasu and of course Toppo. But maybe when it comes down to discussing the realm of strength, it's highly probable that Toppo may hold the advantage in this situation, given the fact that he has the powers of a Hakaishin. And let's not forget, he can also cover himself in energy of destruction, which basically almost makes him invincible to regular attacks, as we've seen against Android 17 and Frieza in the Tournament of Power. Which, all in all, I think that this battle would serve its purpose in the idea that someone has to get the job done quick, otherwise the other person would capitalize in using the entire situation to their advantage in getting rid of the other two competitors. So before we dive any further, I went along ahead and I asked the entire Dragon Ball community on Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat as to who they thought would win the battle between Goku, Toppo, and Merged Zamasu. So without wasting any more time, let us go on ahead and dive into the community and seeing what they had to say in response to this battle.
Alright, so the first person I think be taken out of the fight would be Zamasu. Now, even though he can go into his astral form, he would still pale in comparison power-wise to both Goku and Toppo. Now, somebody may say, oh well, he's astral, they can't destroy him. Well, Toppo's on the level of the Kaioken. Well, he's not on that level, but he's relative to Goku and Vegeta, or on par, I should say. Vegeta is stronger than he is, and Goku was shown to be on par with Vegeta. He was shown to be equal to him. So those two could easily just obliterate Zamasu. So it would come down to Toppo and Goku. And at the end of the day, I think since Goku is a much more skilled fighter and he's also on par and equal with Vegeta, I think Goku would be able to... It would be a hard-fought battle, but I think that Goku would be able to kill Toppo at the end of the day. He would not go down easy, but I think Goku would definitely be able to eke out the win against Toppo.
Well, it's pretty simple. Obviously, Goku would definitely defeat Toppo. Toppo may have his God of Destruction energy, but even Belmont was surprised, and everyone else was, by the fact that Vegeta, in his Super Saiyan Blue evolution form, was able to ignore and counteract Hakai energy. But Super Saiyan Blue Goku is probably on the same level. Plus, he was able to fight Jiren, who was stronger than Toppo himself. So in a Kaioken times 20 form, he would definitely decimate Toppo. But in terms of the battle, he would be damaged quite badly, because Toppo can still hold his own and he is the second strongest of Universe 2. So between a fight between Toppo and Goku to begin with, no backlash about the discussion, Goku would definitely win. But in terms of Zamasu would most likely struggle against Toppo. Like, with destruction energy, he may lose, but like it's been said before, even if his body is destroyed, he still has his astral form, which can still create energy blades, explosions, even erase things, and destroy almost anything. And at the same time, Goku hasn't really got his destruction energy as well, because he may have had that in the manga, but not in the anime continuity. So I still feel like Goku would also lose to Astral Zamasu, who could only be killed by Omni King himself. So basically, in terms of the stacking of the powers, Toppo would lose to Goku, but Goku would definitely lose to Zamasu. So it goes Toppo, Goku, and then Zamasu.
In my opinion, I would say that Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken times 20 Goku would slap Merge Zamasu, no diff, because in episode 65, we see him body Merge Zamasu with the full powered Kamehameha, which obviously skills times 2 of what you are, because back in the Saiyan saga, a Kamehameha to that durability would be at least times 2 of what you would be. So knowing that Super Saiyan Blue Goku bodied at least half of Zamasu and destroying his mortal side and making him destabilize fusion, it was pretty clear that a Super Saiyan Blue Goku, in terms of that, was able to at least damage enough to get Merge Zamasu on floor. And then you can say, okay, well, Zamasu was suppressed. If that's the case, then later on, even Kaioken times 2 Goku was able to outsmart him and even do more damage. So Merge Zamasu was pretty much a dumb fighter, because he let Goku get the best of him twice, and even prior, he lets Vegeta and Trunks outpower him. So that's not really the case. And then you bring in Astral Zamasu, okay, well, then he's as strong as the universe, or he becomes one with the universe. We already have characters back in Battle of Gods that could destroy the entire universe. No, it's literally it's a comical feat now. Back in the tournament of power, it's literally so easy to achieve that feat. Super Saiyan Kefla had one blast in her hand and she could fucking annihilate the whole universe. It's really easy to beat Merge Zamasu in that case. And in terms of Hakaishin Toppo, ASSB or Super Saiyan Blue Evolution Vegeta was able to be on par with Toppo before he had to lose for Tim, until it was the final blast between the final explosion with the Hakaishin blast. Obviously, Super Saiyan Blue Evolution Vegeta was on par with times 20 Goku, as seen in episode 122 when they were both rivaling each other, and he was able to body Toppo with his final explosion. So you can say, okay, well, Hakaishin Toppo was suppressed. The only reason why they said he was suppressed because he couldn't Hakai or kill, aka Hakai is killing.
All right, so first and foremost, right out of the gate, let's talk about Merge Zamasu. I think that's the easiest to discuss, mainly because a weaker, significantly weaker Goku was able to overcome him using his own, not just his own raw power, but also his own tactical and his own skill set as well. He followed up with the Kamehameha wave after he used the Kaioken to basically kick Merge Zamasu in the face and destroy the Ring of Light.
Right.
Even both him and Vegeta were able to work together to even destroy, I think it was his Lightning of Absolution, if I remember correctly. Basically, the purple fake Susanoo bird that he created.
The Lightning of Absolution, yep.
Yeah. So that's Lightning of Absolution. So that's out of the question. I just think at this point in time, Merge Zamasu was completely outmatched, hands down. Now, as far as out of the gate, Hakaishin Toppo is no joke out of the gate in terms of raw power. Mainly because I think a lot of people tend to misconstrue his ability to basically Hakai the World of Void, literally change the World of Void's basically portrayal or its picture, basically. That's can easily be explained, which has nothing to do with his raw power for the most part. So him Hakaiing the World of Void is basically because the World of Void in and of itself has nothing in terms of resistance. It's an infinite world of nothingness. There's nothing to resist the Hakai technique itself. So him warping the World of Void overall isn't a testament to his strength. It's just a testament to the Hakai in general. So is it safe to assume that the Hakai technique should be influenced by the user's level of power? Absolutely. If somebody were to tell me that, I would agree. But considering that the World of Void doesn't necessarily have a resistance of its own or something to fight against or resist against the Hakai, that's exactly why the entirety of the World of Void became warped. So that's not really hard to figure out. Now, moving forward, tactically, Toppo is horrible. I just cannot give it to him.
He has the strength factor, I think, without a doubt. Yeah. But I think that, tactically speaking, I think Goku takes the cake on that one. What do you think?
Easily. Goku, throughout the tournament of power, throughout the history and entirety from Dragon Ball Z coming to Dragon Ball Super, his skill set, the abilities that he's had, his ability to basically, he's a genius fighter. It's been stated multiple times before.
Right.
Like, sure, he might let his guard down every now and then and stuff like that, but against, like, when we saw him fighting Jiren with Vegeta, Goku did not let his guard down for the most part. So when a major and important fight comes across him and it's someone that's that can push him into a corner and stuff like that, Goku does not let his guard down. He fights you head on. So his skill set, his ability, and just his overall fighting genius, he is a fighting genius, easily goes to Goku for sure.
What about Zamasu's endurance factor? Because I don't think that Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken times 20 Goku's Kamehameha wave is as strong as Super Saiyan Blue Vegito's final Kamehameha, in which thus I feel like Merge Zamasu's only scapegoat here would be his endurance. I think that his endurance would definitely shine through and possibly even outshine Goku's attacks, maybe even Toppo's attacks. So what are your thoughts on Zamasu's endurance in terms of what he can handle physically from a Kaioken times 20 Goku and a Toppo? Do you believe that he would be able to survive and endure just like he did with Vegito, or do you believe that he would ultimately crumble and his body would just completely be decimated as the fight drags on?
Right, so I think it's important to assess that your durability and your ability to take attacks does not always translate into your attack potency.
Right.
This has been showcased multiple times throughout Dragon Ball Super as well as Dragon Ball Z. It's basically throughout history. Throughout Dragon Ball's history in terms of fights, people have been able to take attacks significantly stronger than them. One example is in episode 110, when the Genki Dama exploded or basically imploded in front of Goku, it stated that his own power resisted the bomb. And instead of it damaging him, it ended up supplying him with a temporary source of power.
Right.
Another example is Goku taking attacks from Jiren, and these attacks were significantly stronger than Goku, which explains why he was basically getting bullied by Jiren. And yet, just because he was able to take those attacks, he never once output it. On the offensive side, he never once was able to output or dish out that level of attack power, which became equivalent to Jiren's offensive capability, which is why Ultra Instinct Omen was necessary at that point in time. So the list goes on and on. There's been many times where Goku, even 17, for example, was taking hits from Jiren, 17 self-destructed and so on and so forth. So like Frieza got Hakai'd by Toppo, and Toppo was significantly stronger than Frieza.
Right.
And then Toppo even made this thing like, oh, you survived. Almost as if to say that he tried to kill him, which is weird considering that he goes on to later say that he can't risk destroying people anyway, so it's kind of weird. But for the most part, we know that characters are able to take attacks and sustain damage that is significantly greater than what they can dish out on the offensive end. So with that out of the way, yes, Merge Zamasu would be able to take attacks from Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken times 20 Goku, but the question is, if one final Kamehameha from Vegito Blue in the Goku Black arc was able to basically just deteriorate Merge Zamasu's ability to regenerate, then we can argue that Goku would be able to do the same exact thing. It's not a question as to whether or not Goku's Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken times 20, an attack by that or a Kamehameha wave by that would be equivalent to the final Kamehameha wave dished out by Vegito Blue. It's just a matter of whether or not, if Merge Zamasu does not have the offensive capability to dish out an attack, which at this point in time, Goku is more than capable of taking, that's where Merge Zamasu ends up losing the fight. He can take hits, but he won't be able to dish them on the offensive end of the spectrum.
I definitely think that Zamasu's outclassed when it comes to power by both God Toppo and Kaioken times 20 Goku, but in terms of endurance, the only thing we have to go based off of is what happened in the anime and the manga, and he was quite, you know, capable of enduring heavy attacks from not only Goku, Vegeta, Trunks, but also a Vegito Blue, and coming out of that unscathed. And I feel like in this fight, he would definitely be able to hold his own. However, it varies as to the attack damage that, you know, Goku and or Toppo can produce in breaking his body apart, because we saw that Vegeta was able to weaken Zamasu to the point where, you know, Trunks' Spirit Sword was able to, you know, get the job done. But in this situation, I think that he loses, but it wouldn't be an easy task for them to destroy his body, or at least allow him to dematerialize and thus not being in this fight, or at least being included in this fight as a formidable opponent. However, who do you think would be the wild card between Toppo, Goku, and Zamasu? Because the fandom is quite divided as to who they favor in this fight, and especially Toppo's ability and the fact that he has God Destruction power. Who do you think would be the wild card in this scenario, and why?
The wild card comes down to whether or not we're considering that if Merge Zamasu's body were to be destroyed and he became Astral Zamasu, I think that would turn the fight in a completely different scenario.
Right.
So that's where things get interesting now, Ken. But I think at that point in time, it comes down to basically whether or not Toppo would be able to Hakai Zamasu, considering that Toppo was able to basically Hakai the World of Void. But the difference here is that you have Zamasu manifesting himself onto the universe, so there is some level of resistance. So I think which is why I'm kind of grateful that this is it's a battle between Merged Zamasu, not Astral Zamasu, even though technically destroying his body would ultimately create an Astral Zamasu theoretically anyway. So that's where things get a little out of whack. I'm not too savvy in terms of like how that would work, but I still don't think Zamasu, even Astral Zamasu, would still have enough offensive power to basically take out Toppo, let alone Goku at that point in time. So that's what it comes down to. Let's not forget, when Zamasu became the universe, everybody was severely weakened anyway. They had no way of fighting him back, and that's where the Omni King became necessary. But I think he would be the wild card for sure, because it just adds a totally new element to the three-way matchup if that were the case. As far as Toppo, I think he would force Goku into also becoming a wild card, because now what you have is that we've seen when Vegeta fought Toppo, Vegeta was pushed into a corner and he's basically got a motivation and slash rage boost or power up, which allowed him to basically bully Toppo. And not just with Ki Blast either, he was literally punching and kicking Toppo throughout, like ping pong him across the Tournament of Power arena.
Right.
Goku has been showcased to do the same thing, if not worse. We've seen many times before where Goku was pushed into a corner against an overwhelming opponent, it triggered Ultra Instinct Omen. And if that were the case, Toppo loses hands down. But I'm only saying, strictly as a Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken times 20, looking at that directly, I'm willing to assume that Goku can also power himself or push himself to those levels of power that Vegeta was all able to obtain, considering that the show kind of dictated for both Goku and Vegeta to be equal to each other, if not Vegeta was marginally stronger in their fight, in their 2-versus-1 fight against Jiren. And then basically they split up and then Vegeta was losing to Toppo until initially he powered up and just went batshit crazy against Toppo. So Goku is more than capable of doing that very same thing, whether or not he's in Ultra Instinct Omen. So it just becomes a matter of Goku getting rage boost and Goku getting a power up at a Zenkai mid-fight like they always tend to do for the sake of the plot. And then after that, it just basically comes down to just Goku being smart enough to basically not only outsmart Toppo, but basically outclass and outperform him from a fighting standpoint. Because it got to a point where the Hokai wasn't even working on Vegeta anymore. Like, Vegeta was punching the actual Hokai, and Toppo had to charge up a massive Hokai against Vegeta's final explosion. And then that's what basically turned everything around. But ultimately, for the most part of that fight, once Vegeta powered up, Toppo, for the most part, did not stand a chance. I'm willing to bet Goku will be able to achieve those levels of power even without tapping into Ultra Instinct Omen, considering that tapping into Ultra Instinct Omen is a exponential power up. It's not a simple times 20 or times 40.
Oh, no,
it's
absolutely. Yeah, I think imperfected Ultra Instinct definitely takes the cake here, because that's something that really, you know, dives deeper into Goku's power. We saw how, you know, different it was when Goku fought Jiren minus Kaioken times 20 into, you know, imperfected UI. But in this scenario, my question to you is, do you believe that Goku would be able to endure, you know, Toppo's Hokai blast, just as, you know, we saw Frieza take the blast, but, you know, he walked away unscathed, or at least battle damage to the point where he was able to stand. But what about Goku here? Let's say, for example, if Toppo were to unleash more of these Hokai blasts, and we saw someone like the likes of Goku take the attack, and even Zamasu, do you see them being able to survive, or do you see at least one of them completely falling by the hands of such power by you know, Toppo's hands?
No, Merged Zamasu would get Hokai'd indefinitely.
So you think his body would be destroyed?
Yeah, there's just no question about that. Toppo will just completely shit-stomp Merged Zamasu.
Okay.
Like, Goku won't even have to fight Merged Zamasu. Toppo will definitively just Hokai him and just erase him completely. And which, at that point, prevents him from becoming Merged Zamasu anyway. Astral Zamasu, sorry. If he's erased, there's nothing you can do. He was erased to begin with by the hands of the Omni King. The reason he was able to become Astral Zamasu was because Future Trunks split him in half, and his actual essence of Zamasu became the universe and manifested and became and took over the entire universe. But Toppo Hokai'ing Merged Zamasu is a completely different ballgame, because he's erased and there's nothing he can do about that. So, which is why I said at the beginning, like, it becomes a little bit of a different scenario as to where if Merged Zamasu were able to become Astral Zamasu, but considering that Toppo is God Destruction Toppo, he can more than likely just Hokai him out of existence, and then it comes down to both Goku and Toppo. Now, as far as Goku, once again, if you are stronger, right? Once you reach a said level of strength in terms of offensive capability, theoretically, or based on what we've seen, based on what the show clearly portrayed many times before throughout the Tournament of Power, you're able to take stronger attacks too. That's just how it works. You get stronger, you can take attacks that you normally wouldn't be able to take before. It's just how it works. So with that, we've seen Toppo, but we've seen Goku he didn't really tank the Hokkaido like that, but he was, you know, he was in the Hokkaido's base, whatever this and that, and he struggled against it. Beerus had to save him. But this is a Hokkaido that Toppo was spamming against a Vegeta who was able to just punch through them no problem. They just stopped working against him. At that point, Goku, yeah, he should be able to take the Hokkaido. See, basically, to beat the Hokkaido, you just have to be stronger than it. To beat that implementation of the Kai, you just simply have to be stronger than it, based on what the show seems to portray lately. But other than that, it just comes down to, would Goku actually get caught in the Kai? Would he be stupid enough to get caught in the Kai? Knowing him, he would. But that's, if anything, that's what would push him into a corner and incite a power-up of some kind. And then he would just break through it and just completely shit-stomp Toppo. Toppo is way too reliant on the Hokkaido. And then when he makes the decision to say, oh no, I can't destroy you, he just resorts to Justice Flash and just no actual combat tactics that put him ahead of the pack. Now, when it comes down to that, Goku's just on a totally, totally different level.
Now, you mentioned earlier, if this was Astro Zamasu, things would have been different. How different would things have been if, let's say, as an example, they were able to destroy Merge Zamasu's body, and as a result, we have Astro Zamasu, as that was canonized in the show? What if the scenario was presented to where now you have, hypothetically speaking, an Astro Zamasu, you know, in the exact, you know, scenario where Topo's fighting Goku? How do you think the fight would have gone on then?
Well, I don't think it would have even happened, just based off of Toppo being able to Hokkaido MZ. Like, I'm pretty sure if he was aware of him being half immortal, so on and so forth, he would just Hokkaido on the spot. But I also would imagine that a massive Hokkaido would be able to take out Merge Zamasu from the sky, if not a multitude of them. Toppo didn't really seem to show any signs of, like, you know, being tired or stressed out after releasing so many Hokkais anyway.
Yeah.
He never really showed any signs of getting tired at all. Am I saying that he cannot get tired? Absolutely not. But what I am saying is that basically, to destroy a universe or some kind of resistance of some kind, you have to just simply be stronger than it. It's just, Dragon Ball's scaling is pretty linear. It always goes up. It never really goes down. It just always continues to go up. If you're stronger than said person, you can damage said person. So Astral Zamasu becoming the universe itself is just him literally becoming the universe itself, I would imagine. Is there some resistance of his own being applied? Absolutely. But Zamasu in general was just considerably weaker than both that Goku and that Toppo. Theoretically, I would imagine that his Hokkaido would be able to just, you know, continue to just decimate Astral Zamasu. But I think we should look at it a little more realistically, as to where I don't think Astral Zamasu would even be taken into consideration, because Toppo would just simply Hokkaido him.
I think by the end of this would be a most interesting contest, because here you have someone like Zamasu who basically cannot die. His immortal essence still lives on, even if his physical body gets destroyed. Then you have Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken times 20 Goku, who is very impressive in his fight against Jiren, and seeing his display in raw overall power throughout the course of Dragon Ball Super. And then we have Hokkaido Shin Toppo, who is absolutely dangerous in having to see what he did against Evolution Blue Vegeta and Golden Frieza. So I definitely feel as if this fight would be a bloodbath between all three candidates. But by the end of this, let me know what you all think down in the comment section below. Which person do you guys feel would be the overall winner of this battle? Who do you guys think would be the person that would prevail the most in this battle, and who do you guys believe is going to be the wild card of this fight? Thank you all so very much for watching, guys. Once again, if you guys have missed out the previous Dragon Ball Super Triple Threat What If battles, I will leave links to all of the playlist videos down in the description box below, so make sure you guys go on ahead and check those out. Make sure you guys are also following me on Snapchat, Instagram, and Twitter. The links to all of those will be located down below to stay interactive and be featured on a future video. Let me know what you all think down in the comment section below. Thank you all once again. If you guys are new, hit that subscribe button, guys, turn on all notifications, slap a like on the video. Let's see if we can actually get to 2,000 likes on this video. If that, we're gonna go on ahead and feature more triple threat battles in the future. Thank you all once again. Make sure you guys also subscribe and check out Emish's channel. I will leave a link to his channel down below. Tune back in for more, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you guys in the next video. Take it easy, everybody. Cue my motherfucking outro, bitch.
This is the perfect being. Before I destroy your favorite heroes, I'm going to need you to subscribe to the perfect channel, UnrealEnt Gaming, and turn on notifications to never miss a single upload. Also, follow UnrealEnt Gaming on these social media platforms to stay connected at all times. And if you don't, then very soon you will all be dead! along with your entire planet.